Welcome to the intro to the physical chemistry playlist. Over this series of videos, we'll be talking about various concepts in physical chemistry, so we need to define what physical chemistry is. So physical chemistry is the use of the laws and general principles of physics to derive mathematical equations and formulas which will allow us to predict the behavior of chemical systems and give us insight into chemistry. So if you're wanting to study physical chemistry, there are some prerequisites which it's a good idea to have some knowledge about before going into it. First one would be general chemistry. So not everything in general chemistry, you don't have to remember every single thing from your introductory courses, but it's a good idea to know the basics, things like what are electrons, nuclei, atoms, you know, how those sorts of things work, different types of bonds like covalent and ionic, you know, the basic skill sets you would get from an introductory course in chemistry. And then in terms of math, I'm going to need a pretty strong fluency in algebra, because even if you understand the chemistry concepts fully, even if you understand the physics fully, when you're manipulating equations, if you struggle to do the algebra, then you're not going to get the correct result, and that would be a shame, because obviously the chemistry is the focus of these courses, but math can hold you back if there are big holes there. So if you feel like you struggle with any concepts in algebra, that would be a good idea to review. And also calculus. Calculus is used fairly consistently throughout the course. You see derivatives, integrals, those sorts of things sprinkled in all the time. Far as derivatives, it's necessary to be pretty fluent with derivatives, things like the power rule, product rule, quotient rule, chain rule, those sorts of things. The basics of how integrals work, you won't have to do many very difficult integrals. If it's something that's going to be very challenging or time-consuming, there'll often be tables for you to look up, but you need to know the basics of how integrals work. And if you struggle in any of these areas here, there are lots of great resources such as Khan Academy that you can use to review those topics there. So within physical chemistry, we've got quite a few subtopics that you can study. And of these, the first two are going to be the focus of the first playlist series. And these would be quantum chemistry, which is the application of quantum mechanics, which is the physics of how very small objects behave, very small objects like electrons and nuclei. That'll allow us to develop models for the behavior of things like atoms, vibrating molecules, rotating molecules, and things like the electrons within alkenes and all sorts of different topics. And then once you study how those interact with light and photons and how they change energy levels, you get into spectroscopy, which is how most chemical properties are probed nowadays, using some type of spectroscopic method like UV-Vis, infrared, NMR, all the various types of spectroscopies there are. Statistical mechanics is basically we're taking information about these energy levels of individual atoms or molecules, which we're getting from quantum mechanics, and then building up from the ground up from one individual molecule to the behavior of very large things. So going from the behavior of a single water molecule up to, you know, an Avogadro's number of water molecules, several ounces of water, how you get macroscopic behavior from microscopic properties. Then looking at the same phenomena from the macroscopic level, you have thermodynamics, which is, heat and energy flow and work and all the different flowing of energy between systems at the macroscopic level. And thermodynamics tells you a lot about energy changes, and what the differences in energies are, but to know the rate of things, how fast things go from one state to another, that needs kinetics. So usually these first two here are pretty much grouped together into one course, and that's what I'll be developing and putting online over the course of the spring 2014 semester. So that's in progress now, and that'll be updated over the course of the next few months as of the release of this video. And then thermodynamics and kinetics are often grouped together into a different course, and that's what I'm going to do in fall of 2014, hopefully keeping up with course sequences there through fall of 2014. So if you're watching this and it's still 2014, that means these videos are still in the process of development. So I'd encourage you to watch videos, leave your comments and feedback both through the YouTube comments, and I also have an email address listed within the channel. So if you want to comment publicly, if it's something you think others might benefit from public discussion, you can do so. You can help influence the direction and of what this channel does over the course of its development. And if you have other private comments that you want to give, you can go to the channel email, and I'll be happy to take your suggestions. I'll be taking feedback very seriously because students are the focus of this series. I'm creating this to try to help out physical chemistry students, because physical chemistry can often be one of the more difficult things to study within a chemistry degree. And hopefully these videos will make that just a little bit easier on you.